Today back then. What happened today in modern history? Let's get most smartest. I usually try to stick with modern history, but biblical scholars generally agree that today, in 33 AD, was the historical crucifixion of Jesus of Nazareth. In 1776, George Washington receives an honorary degree from Harvard College. In 1834, all of the generals in the Greek War of Independence stand trial for treason. In 1848, Thomas Douglas becomes the first public school teacher in San Francisco, California. And now everyone there sends their kids to private school. In 1856, the palace of the Grand Master of the Knights of Rhodes, Greece, is badly damaged by a gunpowder explosion, which also kills 4,000 people. In 1860, the Pony Express mail delivery system, which ran between St. Joseph, Missouri and Sacramento, California, was started today. In 1865, Union forces capture Richmond, Virginia, the capital of the Confederate States of America. In 1882, American outlaw Jesse James is killed today in St. Joseph, Missouri, by Robert Ford. Hey, didn't we just talk about St. Joseph, Missouri a minute ago? In 1885, the German Gottlieb Daimler patents his grandfather clock engine design. In 1888, a brutally murdered woman is found in the Whitechapel district in the East End of London. She is the first of 11, but who is the killer? In 1895, Oscar Wilde's libel trial begins, which eventually results in his imprisonment on charges of homosexuality. In 1897, German classical composer Johannes Brahms passes away. In 1908, today Frank Gotch wins the World Heavyweight Wrestling Championship. Sounds pretty straightforward, but the match lasted 2 hours. In 1913, British suffragette Emmeline Pankhurst is sentenced to 3 years in jail. In 1922, American singer and actress Doris Day is born in Cincinnati, Ohio. Also in 1922, Joseph Stalin became Secretary General of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union, a position from which he seized absolute power. In 1924, iconic American actor Marlon Brando is born in Omaha, Nebraska. In 1927, today, the U.S. state of Ohio moves to the Eastern Time Zone. I hope everyone got their clocks reset. In 1929, the Cunard Line orders a new ship from John Brown and Company. They call it RMS Queen Mary. In 1930, at the second Academy Awards, the Broadway Melody, Warner Baxter, and Mary Pickford win. It is also the first time the Academy Awards are broadcast on the radio. In 1933, the Maple Leafs beat the Canadiens 1-0 after standard play, plus an overtime of 1 hour 44 minutes in the longest hockey game ever to that point. In 1936, Bruno Richard Hauptmann is executed for the kidnapping and murder of the baby son of pilot Charles Lindbergh. In 1940, Soviet troops massacre 22,000 Polish nationals. In 1941, British Prime Minister Winston Churchill warns Soviet leader Joseph Stalin that a German invasion is imminent. In 1942, Japanese forces begin an assault on U.S. and Filipino troops on the Bataan Peninsula. In 1944, the U.S. Supreme Court rules that white primaries are unconstitutional. In 1946, Japanese Army General Homma Masaharu, who ordered the Bataan Death March, was executed. In 1948, U.S. President Harry S. Truman signs the Marshall Plan. Also in 1948, in South Korea, the Jeju Massacre begins, which leads to a period of violence and human rights abuses in the country. In 1953, American magazine TV Guide publishes its first issue. In 1954, Rodgers and Hammerstein's musical Me and Juliet closes at the Majestic Theater in New York City after 358 performances. In 1955, a night express train in Guadalajara, Mexico derails, killing 300 people. Also in 1955, the American Civil Liberties Union announces it will defend Allen Ginsberg's book Howl against obscenity charges. In 1956, the F5 tornado called Hudsonville Standale strikes the Lower Peninsula of Michigan. In 1958, American actor Alec Baldwin is born. Also in 1958, Fidel Castro's rebels attack Havana, Cuba. In 1960, today Elvis Presley records It's Now or Never, Fever, and Are You Lonesome Tonight at RCA Studios in Nashville, Tennessee. In 1961, American funny man Eddie Murphy is born. In 1964, incredible, but the Beatles hold the top 6 spots on Australia's record charts. In 1967, 113 Eastern Europeans attending the World Amateur Hockey Championships in Vienna, Austria, request political asylum. In 1968, American civil rights activist Martin Luther King Jr. delivered his mountaintop speech today. Tomorrow, he will be assassinated. Also in 1968, Planet of the Apes, starring Charlton Heston and Roddy McDowall, premieres in the United States. In 1970, this is just a fun one, I think. Miriam Hargrave of England passes her driver's test on her 40th attempt. Also in 1970, as part of their new Get Tough policy in Northern Ireland, the British Army warns that anyone throwing petrol bombs could be shot on the spot. In 1971, The Temptations hit number one in the U.S. for the second time with Just My Imagination, Running Away With Me. In 1973, on a Manhattan sidewalk, the first public mobile phone call is made today. In 1974, the biggest tornado outbreak in recorded history occurs in the United States. The death toll is 315 people, with nearly 5,500 more injured in what is called the super outbreak. In 1978, at the 50th Academy Awards, Annie Hall, Richard Dreyfuss, and Diane Keaton win. In 1979, Jane M. Byrne is elected the first woman mayor of Chicago, Illinois. In 1981, the Osborne 1, the first successful portable computer, is unveiled in San Francisco. Also in 1981, race riots break out in London, England's Brixton area. In 1985, in London, England, Vic Elliott pockets 15,780 pool balls in 24 hours. In 1986, the United States national debt hits $2 trillion. Yes, that's how many zeros there are in 2 trillion. In 1987, Bill Elliott sets a NASCAR record of nearly 215 miles per hour at Talladega Speedway. I wonder if Tom Cruise used his voodoo magic. Get it? In 1988, Mario Lemieux wins the NHL scoring title and stops Wayne Gretzky's 7-year streak. In 1990, American singer, the great Sarah Vaughan, passes away today. In 1991, Penn & Teller's Refrigerator Tour opens at the Eugene O'Neill Theater in New York City. Also in 1991, the NFL's Bo Jackson signs a 1-year contract with the MLB's Chicago White Sox. In 1995, Howard Stern gets in hot water for his disparaging remarks about deceased singer Selena. It's doubtful that he cared. In 1996, Unabomber Ted Kaczynski is arrested. Also in 1996, a United States Air Force airplane carrying the Secretary of Commerce Ron Brown crashes in Croatia, killing all 35 people on board. In 1997, in Algeria, all but one of the 53 inhabitants of Tlilit are massacred by armed forces. In 2000, a U.S. federal court rules that Microsoft violates United States antitrust laws by keeping an oppressive thumb on its competitors. In 2004, the Islamic terrorists involved in the March 11, 2004 Madrid attacks are trapped by the police in their apartment and they kill themselves. Good riddance. In 2007, Rolling Stones guitarist Keith Richards denies that he ever said he smoked his father's ashes. Such an odd thing to have to deny. In 2008, they were once one of the 10 largest U.S. passenger airlines, but today ATA files for bankruptcy and ceases all operations. Also in 2008, Texas law enforcement surrounds the FLD's YFZ ranch. Eventually, 533 women and children are removed and taken into state custody. In 2008 as well, Mariah Carey's Touch My Body becomes her 18th number one U.S. hit, which officially beats Elvis Presley's 17. But she is still behind the Beatles, who had 20. In 2009, Australia formally adopts the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. In 2012, the country of Spain announces that their unemployment has reached a record high, with youth unemployment itself at 50%. Also in 2012, U.S. President Barack Obama officially secures the Democratic presidential nomination again. In 2013, 46 people are killed and 100 are injured in a courthouse suicide bombing in Afghanistan. In 2013 as well, 50 people are killed by flooding across Argentina. Also in 2013, 24 people are killed when a bus runs off a cliff in New Guinea. In 2016, in one of the biggest leaks of confidential data in history, the Panama Papers were revealed after being found in a Panamanian law firm. In 2019, the country of Brunei begins new Sharia laws which punish gay sex and adultery with death by stoning, which prompts worldwide condemnation. In 2020, U.S. aircraft carrier Captain Crozier is cheered off of his ship after being fired because of a letter he wrote demanding more help for his sailors infected with COVID-19. And lastly, also in 2020, 27 people are swept off of a ferry and are feared dead in the Solomon Islands during Cyclone Harold. So that was today's episode. I'm sure you liked it. Make sure you look at more of my episodes, or at least listen to them. They're great background noise and nothing else, so that you can learn something new and get most smartest. Talk to you tomorrow.